This isn't the Bureau's first time in Bright Falls. 1970, 76, 8. Last one was in 2010. It's not exactly clockwork, but this town sees way more altered world events than most. We knew it was just a matter of time before the lake acted up again. After the AWE in 2010, the FBC's research department set up a facility, the Lake House, to study the threshold in Cauldron Lake, find better ways to contain the entity inside. Your tax dollars at work. When we detected a spike in paranormal activity at Cauldron Lake, before I even knew you were on this case, Saga, the Lake House was my first thought. I was shorthanded, hoped they could spare some help, maybe give us some intel on the situation. If I had any clue what was waiting for us in there, Saga, I'd have just kept on driving. This is Agent Kieran Estevez responding to an AWE alert in the vicinity. I need to speak with the Marmonts. So much for the welcome wagon. You all set up the perimeter. We're on the threshold's doorstep, so keep your eyes peeled.
Yes, ma'am.
This shouldn't take long, okay? You see anything, radio me.
Roger that.
The Lake House was run by the research department. Research and investigations don't really see eye to eye. What they call science, I call a violation of Bureau protocol and human decency. Classic interdepartmental drama. Your FBI saga, you know how it goes. Now, in retrospect, my low opinion of the research department may have clouded my judgment. Hello? Agent Kieran Estevez, Investigations Department. No one wants to check the individual carrying a firearm into a restricted government facility?
Hello.
No?
And welcome to another exciting day here at the Lake House. As I'm sure you know, I am Dr. Jules Marmont, and this is my wife,
Dr. Diana Marmont.
And together, we are the heads of research at this facility. We want to thank you all for helping us break new ground in our study of Cauldron Lake.
That's right, Jules. But don't let our exciting work in threshold regulation and dimensional coupling keep you from observing the proper safety protocols.
You said it, Diana. We run a tight ship here at the Lake House. So, always remember the three S's. Safety, security, and censorship.
It's a C.
Why? Yeah. That is the joke, Diana.
Well, it's a stupid, wonderful joke, Jules. We'll see you down there.
Yeah, that seems healthy. That's handy. An experiment. That bodes well. Dr. Marmont's not here. Nobody is? I'll have to check downstairs. They must all be working on the lower levels. I'll need to head down.
Access denied.
Well, you are not keeping me out. I'll need a key card with clearance. Locked. Changing passwords, huh?
Thank you.
This should get me downstairs. As soon as I got in that elevator, my bad news detector started going nuts. Estevesta team, something's going on in the lake house. I want all nearby agents to—
Oh, shit!
The threshold event had hit the lake house. Now, it was the Marmont's problem. Our mission was outside. What the fuck was that? Need to get back to the elevator. Priority one, get the lights on. Standing around in the dark near Cauldron Lake, you're not smart. Not a regulation FBC weapon. Can't open it from the side. Jules's key card could be useful. Wish they'd make these things lighter. The way I saw it, there was only one way out. Identify the source of the event and contain or eliminate it. Now, good news, I just had to keep going down. Bad news, the elevator liked to disappear. Elevator's back. This key card won't get me in. You never really get used to the shit you see in this job, but you can learn techniques to adjust, to function. Take 6 deep breaths, then get to work. Find the source, collapse the threshold. So what kind of entity are you?
Murder and victim. The anger.
You can speak. That means you probably imprinted on a person or retained some of your former self's information. Previously human, maybe? Okay, I can work with that. I had an unpleasant encounter with some other painted individuals. Any relation?
A thousand paintings used, crude.
What does that mean?
Paint, no brush, a self-portrait!
Okay, hey, hey, calm down!
Firing his eyes and hands and bones!
Bad news? That thing is really pissed off. Good news. It didn't try to kill me. Okay, baby steps.
Angry living paintings are not typically on the Cauldron Lake bingo card. Something different was happening at the lake house, and I couldn't let it escape. Bright Falls didn't need this particular cherry on its already shitty sundae.
Sublevel 3.
Lane stood back from the canvas. He didn't recognize the piece. Did he paint this? His mind was foggy, unfocused. He knew the Marmonts were putting something in his food. Diana and Jules Marmont had once been a team. Rising stars in the Bureau, both talented in their own way. Diana innovated and Jules got funding from the bureaucrats. Cooperation led to respect.
September 12, 2023. Notes regarding a page of an Alan Wake manuscript I found in the archives. I checked the records, and this page is not in our inventory. I believe it manifested inside the lake house directly. I won't be filing this page. It'll just send Jules into a panic. The page is written in Wake's usual style, so I can't say for certain if it's being literal or figurative when it calls us monsters. But what's interesting is that the page indicates that a painting succeeded in linking Cauldron Lake's threshold with our facility. Writing has always been the clearly superior avenue of research, but I never considered that the writing itself would dictate a different art form as the catalyst for our success. I cannot accept that. I can't allow Jules to stumble his way into success. Not after the years of work I put into this research. Word yesterday that two riders are visiting Bright Falls. I will beat Jules to the finish line.
Marmonts had let the lake in, but the water could not flow. It became trapped, stagnant, went bad. The truth was controlled here. The art was not art, just content for the experiment. There was a crack in the lake house. The Marmonts had let the lake in. But the water could not flow. It became trapped.
Typewriters. Please don't let. As you know by now, typewriters and Cauldron Lake do not mix. And a room full of them all clacking away? 100% bad news. Need a higher clearance keycard. Thank you.
7th, 2018. Notes regarding Dr. Emil Hartman, founder of the Cauldron Lake Lodge, where he manipulated artists in an attempt to control the power of the Shadow. I've gone through his notes, which were confiscated by the Bureau after his arrest in 2010. Overall, Hartman's work was sloppy. Complete disregard for proper scientific method. But he was bold enough to try something we haven't. Our procedural writing machines are promising, but we could understand the effects of Cauldron Lake's threshold much better by observing live artists in action. Thanks to Hartman, we even have a list of prospects. Next step is to send Dr. Darling a request to bring some into the lake house for analysis.
Back where I started. Spatial recurrence usually observes the law of three.
This contrived overlap. Compressing, compounding, reflecting. Three should be the last one. I keep coming back to this page. Walter's coming in link. Thank you.
locked. Maybe there's another way in. Shifting phenomena.
Alan Wake's writing is being studied here. Do you know anything about him?
Names don't matter. A thousand more to come.
They say clear communication is the key to any relationship. You and I have some work to do there. What happened to you? Did the people here do this to you?
Mormons! Claudine is dead!
You said Mormons before. Do they do this? Where are they now?
Misery! Hate.
Tell me where they are! Fixated on the Mormons. What did they do?